is the North Pole.
No, it's not.
Yes, it is.
No, it's not.
Yes, it is.
No, it isn't.
Yes, it is.
No, it isn't.
Yes, it is.
No, it's not. Where's the snow?
Why are you smiling like that?
I just like to smile. Smiling's my favorite.
Make work your favorite. That's your favorite, okay?
Okay.
Work is your new favorite.
Fine.
Time for the announcement. Okay, people, tomorrow morning, 10 a.m., Santa's coming to town.
Santa! Oh, my God!
Santa here? I know him. I know him.
He'll be here to take pictures with all the children.
Yeah.
Just keep the receipts. 10 a.m. tomorrow.
10 a.m. tomorrow.
Santa's coming to town.
Yes.
Any signs for me?
Oh, hi. Santa's coming.
And every time it rains, Panties from Heaven.
Shooby-dooby.
Don't you know each cloud contains Panties from Heaven?
Shooby-dooby.
You'll find your fortune falling all over town. Be sure that your umbrella is up, upside down. And trading for a package of sunshine and ravioli.
Macaroni.
If you want the things you love, you must have a piece of holy baby. And when you hear thunder, don't run under a tree. Every pen is from heaven for you and me. Now come over here, boy. Sam. Mm-hmm. I knew I'd get you. Let's go. Let's go.
Sing alone, you can sing in front of other people. There's no difference.
Actually, there's a big difference.
No, there isn't. Wait. I'm singing. I'm in a store and I'm singing. I'm in a store and I'm singing.
Hey! There's no singing in the North Pole.
Yes, there is.
No, it's not.
We sing all the time.
No, it's not.
Especially when we make toys. See?
I really can't stay.
Baby, it's cold outside.
I've gotta go away.
But I can call you a ride.
This evening has been
so glad
so
you dropped
very in. Nice.
Time spent with you is paradise.
My mother will start to worry.
I'll call the car and tell them to hurry.
My father will be pacing the floor.
I used to live in home
so
for
really I'd better stay.
His name is Murray.
Christmas
some records on a few more.
Would well my friends,
I think they should rejoice.
If I have one more cup,
cream and sugar your choice.
Oh, you really know how.
Your eyes are like starlight now.
One
look at you and I can sure tell.
I want to say no.
You really ought to go.
At least I'm gonna say that I tried.
But we just pulled up outside.
I really can't stay.
Should explore.
I gotta get home.
Or maybe I'm well aware.
Say, lend me your coat.
Or keep it, girl, I don't care.
You've really been grand.
Feels good to sing
but
with my
don't
friends.
You see?
If you don't want to sing, it's not up to me.
There's bound to be talk tomorrow.
Well, they can talk, but it ain't
at least we sing and we didn't lie.
Sing again Christmas time.
I really can't.
What name could contain such a glory? In the cool breezes of Eden, brought from the infant earth, one arose, the voice of his creator speaking his identity to life. Adam, man. And as heaven waited short with breath, the creator spoke yet another, Eve, mother of all the living. So it was with Abraham, named in the promise as the father of nations. Peter, the rock upon which the church would stand. The name called to life the destiny within. The name set the stage for all that was to come. And unto us a child was born. And what name could contain his glory? For he was mighty God, as the universe gasped into being, flinging rays of light from his presence to pierce the void, to shatter the shadows to a tapestry of color. And he is mighty God, shattering our darkness, revealing our light, our truth in him. He was everlasting Father when orphaned Israel needed a father's touch. When we, with grief-stricken cheeks, need the embrace of one who never leaves. When we have lost our way to dark horizons, it is our everlasting Father who lights the way home. He is Prince of Peace. When, like Elijah, we need the still small voice in the turmoil's midst. When, like David, we need the melodies of his presence to soothe our troubled minds. He is sanctuary within our trials, shepherd guiding us to still waters. And yes, he is wonderful counselor. God who gives counsel in the chaos, crafting disorder into calm and failure into beauty. He is a voice for the voiceless. He is dignity for the stateless soul. It is he who raised up a lowly shepherd to become a king. He who took the fishermen of Galilee and made them leaders of history. It is the counselor who redeems our lost years, breaking chains that have kept dreams imprisoned and joy confined. The name reaches across eternity, exclaimed by the splendors of galaxies, sung by the passions of angels, roared in heaven's fervor, exalted in creation's unfettered rejoicing. What name could contain him? What title? What soul renown? For this is our wonderful counselor. This is our mighty God. This is our everlasting Father, our Prince of Peace. What name could contain Emmanuel, God with us, Yahweh, the great I am? What name could contain the Word of Life, the Light of the World, the King of Kings, the Lord of all? We bow to the name that holds every other in its matchless worth. What name could contain such a glory? What name but Jesus? We cry Jesus. We cry holy is the name.
How many of you guys know Jesus is the reason we're celebrating right now? Come on, somebody, go ahead and give him some praise. Let him know that we're celebrating him. Let him know that we know the reason for the season. Let him know that we know that a king was born on that first Christmas. Our Savior, our Redeemer, our Deliverer, the one who came to set us free, the one who came to restore our relationship back with the Father, the one who came from heaven when we couldn't make heaven because he wanted us to make heaven. Thank you, Lord. You're so good. That's what Christmas is all about. And his name is Jesus. Amen. Does anybody love Jesus beside me? Come on, somebody. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I'm just so grateful right now. Just so grateful for the goodness of God. He's just so good. I tell you, I just loved all that singing. I think everybody did awesome. I'm just so blessed right now that we're able to have church tonight. that the devil couldn't stop it. Come on, can we just go ahead and rejoice a little bit? Thank you, Lord. You can stop this. I'm so grateful. We're live streaming tonight. Come on, God is so good. The devil didn't want this. You know what? But yet we're having church. And we're celebrating the birth of our Lord and Savior, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. You're just so good. You're so good. You're so good. You're so good. God, I'm just grateful. Amen. I just tell you, I don't know what it is, but just something about these services, I get teary-eyed. I don't know. I just do. I get teary-eyed. It's like every video just starts, I'm like, oh, I just want to cry. But it's just, I know it's just the love of God. And seeing God work in so many different lives, it blesses me. Grayson, I'll tell you what, she could just sing, man. It's just like, come on. Amen. And I'm just so proud of everyone. And I'm just blessed to be a part of this myself. Even though I'm the pastor, I'm blessed to be a part of this because, I'm the under-shepherd. He's the true shepherd. And I'm just blessed to be able to be a part of all this just like y'all. Isn't God good? That's not a cliche. Somebody say, God is good. He is so good. He is so good. And so let me just take off. But the first thing I want to do is I just want to open up with saying, I'm not opening up with no elf jokes, so you're okay. Though I love the elf jokes. I thought they were funny this morning, but anyhow. But I want to just open up with sincerely saying Merry Christmas. Because I know some of y'all, I might not see, from now to Christmas, but I will see you in the new year. Amen. In Jesus' name. But I just want you guys to know, truly from Becky and I's heart, we love y'all. Merry Christmas. I want to say that up front. So can you tell somebody, I know we just can't be hugging on each other and stuff, but can you just tell somebody Merry Christmas? We can do that. Just say Merry Christmas. I just love hearing Merry Christmas. Amen. Merry Christmas. I just love hearing that. You don't hear that as much anymore, but I love hearing Merry Christmas. I'm cool with Happy Holidays, but I just like Merry Christmas. Amen. Amen. And so, being this is our candlelight service, I'm not going to do a Christmas Coat of Hells message tonight. I'm going to do a different message tonight, and I'm going to do a message on the subject of, and you guys can get ready, on the subject of the wonder of His light. The wonder of His light. Has anybody been wondered by His light? Has anybody ever just been wondered by the light of Christmas? And how many of you guys know the light of Christmas is Christ, the light of the world? Just wondered by His light. And so the wonder of His light is how a light from a Bethlehem star guided wise men. Think about this. On that night, that Bethlehem star guided the wise men. How that light lit the night for the shepherds. How it signaled the way for Emmanuel, God with us. And how it led the wise men to Jesus, who is the light of the world. And that is the wonder of light. Can I get an amen? John 8:12 says this, and these are some very familiar passages of scriptures I'll be reading, and it says this in John 8:12. It said, then Jesus spoke to them again, saying, I am the light of the world. He who follows me shall not walk in darkness, but have the light of life. Come on, just thank Him right now. Lord, I just thank You that I have life and that I have light. I've got Jesus inside of me, the life giver and the source of light. In other words, He said, he who follows me shall not walk in darkness, but have the light of life. In other words, when you follow Jesus, He will be your sunshine by day, and He will be your starlight by night. When you follow Jesus, He will be a lamp unto your feet, and He will be a light unto your path. When you follow Jesus, He will be that inner light or that fire in your heart, so you can be a light in a dark world. And He will be a beacon of light, so that you will always have His light. Not only on earth, how many of you guys know, also for eternity? That's the wonder of His light. And His name is Jesus. He is the light of the world. Come on, somebody. Just go ahead and celebrate Him one more time. Thank You, Lord. Hallelujah. You're so good. You're so good. I've been wondered by His light many times. And it just wows me on how His light just constantly amazes me. Meaning that God reveals things that nobody else can reveal. Come on, can I get an amen? God just begin to reveal things. They're saying sometimes that we're battling in life and we don't know the why or the how come or how do I do this or where do I go next? And it's just amazing how you begin to call upon Jesus. How many guys knows the light of the world? You begin to call upon Jesus, who is the light of the world, and he begins to shed some light on some things. And when he sheds lights on things, he reveals things to you. It's amazing how God can reveal things to you. But the truth is, and I'll get into this in a moment, the truth is we need the light. We need the light. You say, Pastor, why we need the light? Because darkness is constantly trying to hide things from us that only the light can reveal. Can I get an amen? Come on, somebody. Amen. So number one is this. The wonder of his light is how it causes you to see what darkness tries to hide. That's good right there. I'm going to say that again. The wonder of his light is how it causes you to see what darkness tries to hide. Now think of this. It amazes me, and I don't know about y'all, but it amazes me of the very first time the universe hears the voice of God, it hears this: let there be light. The very first time the universe, the darkness, the very first time it hears the voice of God, it hears, let there be light. Now let me read this to you in Genesis 1:1-3. I'm going somewhere with this. And it says this. It says, in the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. Who created it? You can't always listen to what the Discovery Channel tells you. Can I get an amen? You got to go back to the word. Come on. God is not a man that he should lie. He said, in the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. The earth was without form and void, and darkness was on the face of the deep. And the Spirit of God was hovering over the face of the waters. Man, just think of that. Then God said, let there be light. And what happened? And there was light. Whew, thank you, Jesus. Church, I'm just going to throw a quick side note in here. When we see darkness on the earth, we need to do what our Father has already taught us to do. When the Father saw darkness on the earth, he said, let there be light. And it was so. And there was what? Light. Church, we need to awaken. In these dark times, in these difficult times, and the seasons that we're in, they may be difficult seasons, but I know a God in heaven, listen to who is the creator of the seasons. Time does not stop him. Time does not define him. The devil is a liar. And there is something greater than the darkness that we're facing on this earth, and his name is King Jesus. He is the light of the world, and when we see the darkness that's coming against us, church, we need to rise. Arise, I pray for revival. But listen to me, church, you got to understand something. I know, I believe revival is already happening, but revival starts with you on the inside. And let that fire stir up on the inside and then begin to speak against anything that's coming against you. I always tell the church all the time, when the devil pushes me, I push back. Come on, can I get an amen? I don't just go, oh, leave me alone. I push back, but I don't push back with Paul's word. I push back with God's word, because that's where the power is. Because if you go back to the beginning and you read, it says, God said. God said. God said. Not Paul said. God said. God said. This is what God said. God said. God, and if God said it, it's got to happen in the name of Jesus. Can I get an amen? Good stuff. So I love it that he said, let there be light. He didn't say, let there be joy. He didn't say, let there be hope. He didn't say, let there be peace. He didn't even say, let there be love, but he said, let there be light. Why? Why light? Why light first? Why? Why? I believe this. Because it's the light that will cause you to see the joy of Jesus. Because I believe it's the light that causes you to lay eyes on the hope of the world. I believe it's the light. Come on, somebody. It's the light that will cause you to behold the Prince of Peace. I believe it's the light that will cause you to know the love of the Father. Come on, somebody. That's what happened to the wise men that night. The light caused them to see what darkness tries to hide. It was the light, that starry night, that starry light, the light of Bethlehem, that light caused them to see where the child was born, caused them to see, which led them to Jesus. The very thing darkness didn't want them to see, the very thing darkness didn't want to be revealed to them, God said, I'm going to reveal it to them. I'm going to reveal it to them. Let there be light. Light begin to reveal to them some things that the devil is trying to hide from you, trying to hide from the church. What do you mean there's no hope in this world? I feel like there's no hope. No, there's hope. I said there's hope. As long as there's light, there's hope. You need to shed some light on the situation. You need to realize there is hope. Can I get any? I don't know if I can have joy. I'm going through difficulty. Yes, you got the joy of Jesus on the inside of you. Remember what the light of his word says. Come on, somebody. You got Jesus on the inside of you. You got joy already on the inside of you. Amen. How many of you guys know even faith needs light to see? Faith needs light to see the invisible. Faith needs light to believe the impossible. Faith needs light to expect the incredible. That's the wonder of his light. Can I get an amen? Light. It's the light of his word that fuels your faith. Come on, somebody. It's the light of his word that fuels your faith. Amen. Come on. So number two is this. The wonder of his light is how it alone leads you to divine results. I'm going to say it again. The wonder of his light is how it alone leads you to divine results. Man, that's powerful. So much I could share on that. I'm going to put it to you this way. Only the light of the Holy Spirit can lead you away from the danger of darkness and the temptation of sin. That's it. I'm going to read point number two again. I'm going to try to do this in a timely fashion. I know we got kids in here, but hear me out. The wonder of his light is how it alone leads you to divine results or a godly outcome. Only the light of God's word can lead you to a godly life. No other way. No other way. I want to change. I want to change. I want to change. I want to change. Listen to me. There are a lot of things out there that can provide temporary solutions. I agree. There are a lot of things. You can read 10 steps to this and 5 steps to this. And you can see. You can go see a psychologist. And you can do all these different things. Medication. You can try all these different things. But listen to me. Those are temporary fixes. I don't want just a temporary fix. I want to be healed and I want to be whole. Come on, somebody. I want to be healed and I want to be whole. And listen to me. I know who my healer is. Come on, somebody. He said, by my stripes, you were healed. Can I get an amen? He is my healer. He is my redeemer. He is my deliverer. Devil, you better step back because he's done set me free. And he who the Son sets free is free indeed. I've done had an encounter with the light. I know what the light can do. Darkness, you better step back because I already know what the power of the light can do through a life. My life has been changed by the power of his light. That's why we have no need to fear darkness, because you won't fear darkness when you know what the power of the light can do. Come on, somebody. Amen. It's good stuff. The wonder of his light is how it alone leads you to divine results. Only heaven's light can lead you to your heavenly purpose. Can't get that anywhere else. I want to know my purpose is. You need to go to the one who created you. I want to know why I'm on earth. You need to go to the one who allowed you to be here at such a time as this. And his name is Jesus. Can I get an amen? We're not here just to take up empty space. Come on, somebody. You have a purpose. You have a calling. I don't care what age you are. don't allow yourself to think that you're so biblically intelligent that you have no need for God anymore. God, I know enough. No, his ways are not our ways. Matter of fact, his ways are so much higher than our ways. And if you want to know his ways, you got to continue to know his word. Because he's the only one that can reveal it to you. Come on, somebody. Don't live life just thinking you're occupying space. Live life with a purpose, knowing that heaven has a calling, that God has gifted you. God has put you on this earth for such a time as this. God has you here for something specific that he wants you to do, that nobody else can do. He's equipped you to do it. He's equipped you to do it. God has something. You're just not here to work 9 to 5. You're here to worship 24/7. Come on, somebody. Worship isn't just singing. How many of you guys know it's not just lip service? It's a life of service. It's living my God, putting my hand to the plow and not looking back and keeping my eyes on Jesus. And I keep pressing on when things come against me. I keep pressing for it. And I keep my eye on the prize. I keep my eye on the goal, knowing that I'm going to finish my race strong. Come on. Can I get an amen? But I don't know where I'm going, but the light can reveal that to you. Come on. Amen. Many times I don't know what the next step is. Well, you're a pastor. You need to know. No, that God knows. I have to trust and rely on him. Amen. I don't always know. But I know I can trust him. I can trust him to shed some light on the situation. And he can reveal it to me. Can I get an amen? Well, this is good stuff right here. Hallelujah. Only Jesus. How many guys know only Jesus, the light of the world, can lead you to spiritual, physical, and emotional health? Only Jesus. Only Jesus can do that. Now watch this in Matthew. I'm going to read something to you. This is powerful. In Matthew 2, verses 9 through 10. And this is the journey of the wise men. The journey of the wise men. And this journey, I believe it reveals to us, or it shows us, how following the light of the star will always lead to a godly outcome, or you could say divine results. I don't know about you. I could use a lot of divine results in my life. Anybody else but me? Come on, somebody. Anybody else but me? I just got to thank you for clapping over here. Anybody else can use some divine results? Godly outcomes? I don't know about you. I need the hand of God on my life. I need the hand of God on my life. Lord, lead me, guide me, show me what to do. Can I get an amen? And that's what he does. He wants to guide us. He wants to lead us. He wants to do, I want divine results in my marriage. I want divine results in my finances. I want divine results in my kids and my grandkids. I want to see heaven's hand move on this situation. Why? Because I want to leave a legacy. But see, I want my legacy not to be about Paul. I want my legacy to be about Jesus. I want my grandchildren and their children's children to be able to say, Popo, they call me Popo. Y'all, hey, don't make fun of me. I know some of y'all grandchildren call y'all. I'd rather be called Popo than, I won't say, than Santa Claus. But anyways, Popo. Popo loved Jesus. Popo taught me how to pray. Popo taught me how to go to church. Popo taught me how to lay my hands on myself and pray for healing. Can I get an amen? I can't get to the doctor right now, but I know Jesus. Amen. And I lay hands on myself and say, in the name of Jesus, I'm healed. Amen. Hallelujah. I tell you, you get your grandchildren to do that, or your children to do that, I tell you, that's probably one of the greatest things you'll ever see, besides them giving their life to Jesus. Amen. Hallelujah. I need divine results. Somebody say, I want divine results. Divine results. Matthew chapter 2, verses 9 through 10. It says, when they heard the king. Now, this is after King Herod done had a little private interview with the wise men. And then in the New King James, and in the King James, it'll say, when they heard the king, this is after they heard the king, they departed. And behold, the star, the light, which they had seen in the east, went before them. Now, I've shared this many times before, but you got to realize that the light should always go before us. Two things here. I'm just going to quickly say, two quick sightings. Number one, never get ahead of God. I'm going to say that again. Never get ahead of God. Never get ahead of God. God should always be before us. And number two, that means God always comes first. Come on, somebody. Right away. And so he said he had seen the star which they had seen in the east went before them. After the comet, it says this, till it came and stood over where the young child was. That's Jesus. Verse 10, when they saw the star, when they saw the star, now just remember this because I'm going to come back to it. When they saw the star, they rejoiced with exceedingly great joy. When they saw the star, they rejoiced with exceedingly great joy. How many guys know that's a lot of joy? They're excited. They're excited. Now, let me say it this way. When they saw the star, I'm going to say it this way. How many of you remember the first time you saw the light? How many of y'all remain the very first time that you saw light? Meaning, do y'all remember the time you gave your life to Christ? Do you remember the day that you became born again? Do you remember your Independence Day? Come on, somebody. The very first time that you saw the light. They saw the star, and they saw the light, and that's where Jesus, where the young child was born. I know for some of you, you're saying, well, the star didn't lead me to Jesus, but a vessel of light led you to Jesus. Come on. Think about it. Vessels of light. God uses the church. The church is what? A vessel of light. We're also a vessel of living water, but we're also a vessel of light. God uses the church. He used a vessel to lead you to Jesus or to point you to Jesus. Can anybody remember who might have pointed you to Jesus or even led you to Jesus? Can anybody remember that? I remember that. Can we just go ahead and thank God for those people that were a light to us? That were a light to us? I grew up with a big family. We had a lot of family. So whenever grandma said mijo, it's like everybody turned. There's all kind of mijos. Everybody turned around. And so it was like, I think like the first generation, there might have been 8 grandchildren. There was 18 grandchildren. And then there was like 23 grandchildren. It's big, big family. And so I grew up when I was real little. Big, big family. And my daughter's taking a history lesson there. She's like, really, Dad? And so we had all these grandchildren there, and I grew up in a family where not everybody went to church, and you know, it was kind of rough, and I'll just leave it at that. But I'm gonna stick to the positive. But grandma was there, and in the midst of all my crazy uncles and my big crazy family, there was a light in the middle of all that. I know we all talk about that crazy uncle we got or that crazy cousin. But listen to me, I'm going to talk to you about that somebody wasn't crazy. I want to talk about that one person in my family that was a light. Now, wouldn't that be cool if we could just flip the script and quit talking about the crazy people and start talking about the people that love Jesus, that people were a light to us? And I remember, and I'll be honest with you, I remember the crazy people, no doubt. But I tell you what, the one thing that stood out to me was that my grandma was a light. She was a vessel of light. She always talked about Jesus. She always talked about the Lord. Always talked about his goodness. And she always pointed me to Jesus. And I'm so grateful for her doing that in my life. I'm standing here today as a pastor because she was willing to be a vessel of light to me. Amen? And so I'm grateful for that. I'm also grateful for this. I'm going to say this quickly. I'm grateful for a church that points people to Jesus, not a specific denomination or church. Can I just throw that out there? Can I throw that out there? I love that. I love that I'm a part of a church that, listen to me, we point people to Jesus. We don't point people to a man. We don't point people to a certain denomination. We don't point people to a certain church. We point people to Christ. We point people to Jesus. I don't want people to lean on me. I don't want people to lean on a certain denomination. I want them to learn how to lean on Jesus. Put their trust in Jesus, because man will fail you, but God will never fail you. He's the only thing faithful, the only thing true, and the only thing that always stands strong forever and ever and ever. Thank you, Lord, and amen. Thank you, Lord. I'm grateful for that. I didn't say we were a perfect church. See, y'all don't start looking at me funny. But we do serve a perfect Savior. We're not a perfect church. That's going to shock some of y'all. Y'all may have heard me say this before, but I don't believe there is any perfect church. Quiet up in here. The only perfect church, I could tell you where it's at. And I don't think some of you, I don't think any of y'all are ready to go there right now. The only perfect church is in heaven. And I ain't ready to go right now. Amen. Because I think God still wants to do a work in me right here on earth. Amen. And so, but I'm grateful. I'm grateful for those people who are a light to me. A light to me. I'm grateful for a church that wants to be a light, wants to be a city on a hill, shining bright for the world to see. For the world to see. So when they look up and they see that hill, how many of you guys know it's a city on a hill? It's not a person on a hill. Not a person, but a city on a hill. People corporately coming together. Corporately coming together. A city on a hill. Multitudes of people being a light to a dark world. Can I get an amen? I'm grateful for that. And I also want to just say this last little thing. I'm so grateful. I'm grateful, and I know I'm using this time and this service to do this because I feel like it's the best time to do it. I'm just grateful for the people. And I'm grateful for the ministries that are here that point people to Jesus. I want to take a moment right here before we step into the new year to applaud. I want to applaud the dream team here at Rescue Church. I mean that sincerely. You're a light to so many people. You're a light to so many people. Matter of fact, we're going to show some honor. Can y'all come and get on your feet just for a moment, one more time, and applaud our dream team? I'm talking every ministry from Little Feet Nursery to our Impact Kids 24/7 to our Rescue Center. I'm telling you, we have so many different ministries, and I'm just so grateful to y'all. I want to say thank you. Thank you for being a light. You know, we've got some really, I'm telling you, we've got some committed people here. I'm talking committed. I'm talking people that serve God. Serve God once again based upon a heart of devotion, not just emotion. Their hearts are devoted to Him. And I'm so grateful because especially during COVID-19 and all this craziness that's going on, it's tough to fill some spots. But it's amazing how we can't feel this, but then somebody else steps in, and somebody else steps in, and somebody else steps in. So we can continue to do the work that God's called us to do. And I want to take a moment as your pastor to say, I truly appreciate you. I love you, and I thank you from the bottom of my heart. And I'm grateful to God. Grateful for God for you being a vessel of light during these hard times, being a vessel of light. That's why we're able to have church tonight. I love you. And God bless you. Y'all give him one more hand and y'all can be seated. Amen. Amen. I'm going to close with the reading of this scripture. I'm going to close with John chapter 12, verse 46. And I love it. And it says this. This is Jesus talking. He says, I have come as a light to shine in this dark world. I just don't have time to talk about it, but just highlight the word shine and let God speak to you. I don't know about you. I don't want to just be a light. I want to shine. I want to shine bright. I don't want to be just a 75-watt bulb. I want to be a 1,000-watt bulb. I want to shine. I want the glory to be on me. I mean the glory. They're like, whoa, I want the glory all over this church. Can I get an amen? I want to shine. I've come as a light to shine in this dark world so that all, everybody say all. I just want you to know, no matter what translation you read, the word all in the Greek is still the word all. Okay, I just want you to know that for those who believe in the frozen chosen, but I want you to know something. I've come as a light to shine in this dark world so that all who put their trust in me will no longer remain in the dark. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Amen. So here's how I want to close. I want to close with saying this. Will you put your trust in Jesus if you don't know him? Would you put your trust in him? Jesus came to give us the gift of light, and life to anyone who will receive him, to anyone who will receive him. Another way of saying it is this. Anybody got a cell phone in here? Anybody got your cell phone? Some of y'all, and I forgot to tell y'all to, I usually say hashtag I'm ready to receive, but it's okay. Anybody got their cell phone? Could y'all put your cell phones up for me if you got your cell phone? I know not everyone, but most of y'all should have a flashlight feature or app on your phone. And so how many of you guys know our cell phones, they're not a light, but they have the ability to give light. They have the ability to give light. And some of y'all can put your phones up. Yeah, keep them up with the lights on. Go ahead, turn them on. I love this. All these lights on. If you got a light, go ahead and put them up. Mm. And we're fixing to do a candlelight service, so we're going to have our candles up with light. Y'all keep them up. So we got all these phones. And I want y'all to know something real quickly as I begin to close. And y'all go ahead and take the pulpit if you want. Your cell phones have the ability to give light, but the light doesn't come on until you turn the switch on. You have to, not God. God didn't turn it on. You have to turn it on. You have the ability. Everything that you need is in that phone to be able to light up. But the way you turn, you had to be the one to turn it on. I'm here to tell you something. You choose. Do you want the light or do you want to remain in darkness? I don't know about you. I want the light. And Jesus is the one who will light up your life if you're willing to accept him. Can I get an amen? Y'all can lower your phones now. Amen. Thank y'all for doing that. So cool. Yeah, come on. Y'all give the Lord a hand. Hallelujah. So here's how I want to close. Maybe you're in here. I'm going to say this. Maybe you feel like your light's gone dim. You say, I know Jesus. I know you. I feel like my light's gone dim. I want to pray for you in just a moment. Or maybe you're in here and you say, Pastor, I've never given my life to Christ. I've never put my trust in him, meaning I've never fully surrendered my life to him. And maybe you're in here and you say, I want to make heaven. I want to surrender my life to him. I want the light and the life of Christ in me. I want that. I want that light inside of me. So whether you feel like you've gone dim or you've drifted away from the Lord, or maybe you're in here and you've never given your life to Christ, I want to pray for you right now. If that's you, if you're watching online, real quickly, just hashtag I surrender. Hashtag I surrender. If you're in the room here right now, could you just raise your hand? You say, that's me, Pastor. I want to make sure I'm heaven bound. I want to make sure I have the light and the life of Christ inside of me. I see your hands. Y'all can lower your hands. I'm going to ask you to repeat after me as I lead you in this prayer. Those of you watching online, just repeat after me, wherever you may be watching and worshiping with us right now. Just say, Dear Lord, today I surrender my life to you. Come into my life. Make me new. Help me to live for you every day in every way. Lord, I receive your love, your grace, and your forgiveness. I believe I'm heaven bound in Jesus' name. Amen. Can y'all give them a hand? Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. Well, guys, I hope you guys have been just super, super blessed so far. We're going to close the service with our candlelight celebration. So I'm going to ask my beautiful wife to come up. You can get the candles for us, too. Hallelujah. Get us two candles. Thank you. And this is how we're going to do this. I'm going to ask everyone, if you could everybody just stand for me? Everybody just stand. And I'm going to explain how we're going to do this. The usher is going to light Becky and I's our candles. And after they light our candles, then they're going to go down the rows and they're going to light the ends of the candles on each row. And if you can't, the ushers are going to walk down the rows and try to light every single light that is in the room. If you're a family member and your family's next to you, you can go ahead and help speed up the process by lighting their candle. We're okay with that. But if not, allow the ushers to light the candles. Amen. Let's go ahead and do that. Y'all got some pictures of this? Amen. All right. This is a beautiful thing. A beautiful thing. Beautiful thing. How many of y'all love the light of the world, Jesus? I just love it. I think this is so special. I feel this is just awesome that we're able to still do this in 2020. Amen. Continuing tradition. Being able to do this every year. I'm just so grateful. I'm thankful for the goodness of God that we're able to enter his gates with thanksgiving and praise and be able to rejoice in the goodness of God and the salvation that he's given each and every one of us. Thank you, Lord, that you are Emmanuel, God with us, within us, each and every day. And let this candlelight service be a reminder of the light of Christ that is inside of you, so that when you leave this church, that when you go out, you begin to celebrate Christmas. Number one, you remember the reason for this season. And number two, so you can remember that you are called to be a light in this dark world. We love each and every one of you. And one last time, we want to say Merry Christmas. Amen. Tell somebody next to say Merry Christmas. You want to say something?
We just want to say again, thank y'all so much for joining us. This is so special. We love all of y'all so much. And you know, it has been a different year. And you know, somebody said, you know, man, I miss those two big trees. We usually have some big giant trees here and here. But when I look here, look what I see where that tree was. I see people right here. Okay? And you know, with COVID and stuff going on, we had to make a little extra room, right? So it was okay to move those trees and make a little more room for you. Amen? But this is what I'm going to say. We're so grateful because we know that there's not everybody's able to do what we're doing tonight, to come together and still celebrate. So we're so blessed to get to do this. But I'm going to say this. I'm going to say that this is amazing, but this... next year, we're going to make up for some lost time. Amen? We're going to make up. We're looking forward to 2021, and we're going to make up for that. And those of you watching online, maybe some of you couldn't be here for all those different things going on all over the place. But listen, we're going to make up for some lost time. Trip, you're watching. We love you, buddy. And it's going to be extra good. It's going to get gooder and gooder. Next year's going to be extra good. Amen? This was great. But it's going to be even better. So we have things to look forward to, amen, that we don't feel bad like, oh, we didn't get to do this or that. No, that we are so grateful that we got to still come together. We're here and we're doing this, and that we have something to look forward to, amen. One last thing. Y'all found some, there's something on your seats when you went to your seat that said something like Rescue Church Family or something. That's for you to take home. That there's a voucher in there for a free turkey from HEB. So some people didn't know what that was in the seat, but take it home. Go to HEB, get your free turkey, and celebrate. Amen.
And if you got two next to you and you say, can I have two? Yes, you can have two. If it's in the seat and your neighbor don't want it, take it, share it, take it, share the love, amen, or keep it and get a double portion, whatever you want to do. Amen and amen. Yes, more than enough. So let's do this real quickly together, everybody together. Let's all quickly just blow out our candle real carefully, guys. It's going to fly up. Yeah, there we go. And on your way out, could you please give the candles to the ushers on your way out? But we're going to dismiss by rows. But before we do that, if you can just hold on to your candle for a moment, we're going to close with a song, Feliz Navidad. But then they're going to go ahead and start dismissing, starting with the back first. We love you guys. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.